Very good morning to all of you. Today we will discuss about introduction of SFD and BMD. It is a topic of strength of material. So in your last semester, you study about the engineering mechanics, and in which you study about the SFD and BMD also, shear force diagram and bending moment diagram. So first of all, we'll talk about the types of supports. The types of support, if I'm talking about type of support, there is one type of support that is simply support. We have to simply put something on a support. Like we put the beam on a column and not tie or any, not made any connection between beam and column. Simply put the beam on the column. So that is a simply support. And in simply support, if I'm talking, in simply support, beam or member can freely move in horizontal direction. But if I'm talking about the joint, about the supports or point of connection between member and supports, so that point of connection cannot move in vertical direction, because the support provides the reaction in the vertical direction. So any deflection in vertical direction, that is zero here, and deflection in horizontal direction, that is possible. So that is non-zero. So we can say that there is, in terms of reaction, if I'm talking in terms of reaction, then vertical reaction is there. So vertical reaction is non-zero and the horizontal reaction is zero. And if I apply any movement on the beam, so this kind of support cannot resist any bending movement. Bending movement on simply support is also zero. So we have to remember that bending movement and horizontal reaction is zero, but vertical reaction is non-zero. In similar way, we have to remember the deflection. Deflection of horizontal and slope is non-zero. And vertical deflection is zero here. So this is a simply support. Then second one is roller support. Okay, in roller support, this is an example of simply support. Okay, so if we provide roller, so a member can move horizontally, but member cannot move in vertical direction. In similar way, member cannot resist the bending movement. So in terms of reaction, if I'm talking in terms of reaction, then vertical reaction is here, horizontal reaction and movement reaction is zero. And in terms of deflection, vertical deflection is zero and slope and horizontal deflection is possible. So that is non-zero. So you have to remember this. Then third one is hinge support. Hinge support, basically hinge support is provided in our gates, the connection between gates. So there we have a hinge support. So in hinge support, the vertical as well as horizontal reaction is there. So vertical as well as horizontal deflection is zero. In simply support, there is only vertical reaction, but in hinge support, there is vertical as well as horizontal reaction. So vertical and horizontal reaction, due to these reactions, the displacement in these two directions is zero. But the movement reaction is not there. So beam can move in clockwise or anti-clockwise direction. So the slope of beam here at the point of connection is non-zero. Slope is possible, but deflection in vertical and horizontal direction is zero. In similar way, movement reaction is zero. So in terms of reaction, vertical horizontal is there, that is non-zero, and movement reaction is zero. But in terms of deflection, horizontal and vertical deflections are zero, and slope is non-zero. So that is hinge support. In next is fixed support, and in fixed support we have three kind of reactions: horizontal as well as vertical as well as movement. So due to horizontal, vertical and movement reaction, there is no displacement as well as slope here. So beam cannot displace in horizontal direction, in vertical direction, and the slope is also zero here. So slope of the beam is like at the connection, the slope is zero, then it will increase. So at the connection, the slope is zero. Okay, so that is about the fixed support. So all three reactions are non-zero, and all the deflection and slopes are zero in fixed supports. Next. Okay, next is shear force. So if I'm talking about the shear force, basically shear force, if we applied any vertical or any perpendicular forces on the beam, lateral forces on the beam, okay, so or any member, so the member can split at any section, at a section. So that vertical force upward and downward can split the member. That is shear force. If I am talking about this section, so the right hand side upward will take positive, and left hand side downward will take negative. In similar, left hand side downward will take positive. If I am talking about negative shear, so if right hand side downward is negative, then left hand side upward is positive. So that is the sign convention of shear force. Then sign convention of bending moment. So if I applied any load on a beam, like this is my beam. And if I apply any load on the beam, then beam will deflect like this. Okay, so there is a possibility that beam, like this beam is simple, let's assume this beam is simply support. So this will behave like this, and if beam is cantilevered, so the beam will behave like this. The deformed shape of the cantilever is this. So in this beam, the movement is, the beam will be sagging due to the load. So this is sagging moment. And the, here if I'm talking about this, and then the beam will be deflect, and the shape is hogging. So that is negative. So we have two kind of movement. First one is sagging movement. Sagging movement is always positive. And second one is hogging movement. Hogging movement is always negative. So next. Okay, so this is a cantilever, and in cantilever at the point B, we have a point load W. So what is the shear force diagram and bending moment diagram? I know you did this activities in your second semester in engineering mechanics. So basically, what is shear force diagram? So shear force diagram, if I'm talking about, then shear force diagram is the sum of the vertical forces or transverse force. Okay. So at any section, if I want to know about the shear force at that section, so I have to sum all the forces either from left side or either from right side. So I have to only summation of the forces. That is our shear force. So at any section, I can calculate the shear force. Only the summation of the vertical forces or lateral forces. So if I am talking about the XX dash section, so what is the shear force? Shear force is negative W, because this is on right side, so, and downward. So that is negative W. It is up to you. You can decide that downward is positive, and if you take downward is positive, then upward is negative. So that is minus W, and this is valid up to B point. So this is minus W, and this is valid up to B point. And here we have reaction. Here we have reaction W, because sigma Fx is equals to zero. In similar way, sigma Fy is equals to zero. So in y direction, we have only one load and one reaction at the support A. So if I'm talking about Ra, that is equal to W, but in opposite direction. So the summation of these two forces must be equal to zero, so that the structure is stable. Okay, so from first point, that is W, up to last point, that is W, and that at point A, we have a reaction, upward reaction, so that becomes zero. So that is a shear force diagram for a cantilever. And if I'm talking about movement diagram, then once again, movement at X, what is movement here? So movement is the summation of the movement from left hand side or right hand side. So if I'm talking about right hand side, so that is W into X. So that is movement. If we have different kind of load here, different set of load, so we have to consider movement due to the all loads. Okay. But either from left hand side or right hand side. So we can calculate right hand from the right hand side as well as from left hand side, but we have to find out the movement reaction, horizontal reaction, vertical reaction, then we can start start from right left hand side. So that is W into X. Okay, W into X, that is movement, and that is clockwise. So clockwise is negative. That negative sign is not because of clockwise or anticlockwise. That negative sign is because of this is hogging moment. In cantilever, the beam behave like this. So there should be hogging moment. So that's why that is hogging moment, and that is minus Wx. And this equation is valid because there is no other load on the span of the beam. So this equation is valid up to A. So movement at D is zero because X is zero. And movement at A is, we have to put the value of X, that is M. So movement at A is minus Wx. Okay. So I hope you got my point. Thank you very much.